That's really what they believe. Now, right? Or, I mean, I'm telling you, that's where they're at.
But and now, so, because they have robotics, as Bill Joy, head of Sun Microsystems, said in the April 2000 issue of Wired, the future doesn't need us. The elite want to get rid of us. Now, I know with you, they're not going to come out and say, hey, we want to wipe everybody out. But I have ABC News here and Times of London, billionaire club and bid to curb overpopulation.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. And I've been sitting on the boats off the coast of Barbados with the guys who basically said, we need to get two-thirds of the dumb people off the planet. I mean, I've been in the meetings, and it wasn't in an evil way. It's a matter-of-fact kind of way that they think it's for the benefit of planet Earth and themselves.
Oh, yeah, they're committed. They've said this is bad genetics. They're passing it on. They're lazy. Here's my next question, and after you finish what you're about to say, it's just, this is so intriguing. This conversation we're having is blowing me away. And I always have done this, you know, as a quote journalist, they say this is off record. People know I don't ever break off the record meetings. I've met with major CEOs, biggest Hollywood people there are, you know, just huge. And they go, Alex, you try to warn them, and look, some listen, most don't. They want to be slaves. They want to die. You know, join us. You're smart. You're good. You know, that's the sales pitch, is that the slaves don't want to be free. But if that was the case, they wouldn't be trying to keep you and me from reaching the people. So it's an overall fraud. But I've had them, you know, at petty level. I'm not like a multi-billionaire like you, who's so much more successful telling the truth. But I've had them offer me millions of dollars and promise more if I'd sell out. So A, finish up with their mindset, and then B, have they tried to buy you off?
Well, they're not concerned, quite frankly, so much with spreading the word because, as you just said, their belief is no one's going to listen anyway. So who cares? It's like, you know, you're more of an annoyance than anything. But actually, they believe that what you're doing and what I'm doing is, in a way, to their benefit because we're desensitizing people to
yes.
these realities.
Yes, absolutely.
And so I've been told that's why I still get invited on the yachts.
Yeah, I've been told that too. And you know, wow, unbelievable.
But in terms of economics, you know, I mentioned to you after break that I was talking to George Soros. He says, you know, and I know a lot of this inside information as well. We're making more money now because of the crisis than you would imagine. I mean, we had bank stocks shorted huge in the fall before they all crashed 90%. I mean, the fortune we made just shorting the bank stocks was off the charts. I mean, that was the simplest, goofiest thing in the world. When I wrote my book, Debt Cures, almost 3 years ago, I was the first guy on national TV to say, look, everyone's a moron. This consumer lending is going to explode. The housing market's going to crash. Foreclosures are going to go through the roof. And what, at Bilderberg, we talked about is the fact that the media is so you don't even have to do anything to the guys on CNBC or MSNBC. They're so stupid. 75% of Americans in the next 2 to 5 years are going to lose their job, get a reduction in pay, or go from full-time to part-time. The taxes
It's a designed changing our standard of living for the New World Order. Kevin, did I hear you correctly? Were you at Bilderberg?
Yeah, I was in Greece. And because I have friends who are there, right now, by the way, you're not going to believe where I'm at. I'm in Rotteck-Egan, Germany, which is where Bilderberg had their meeting a few years ago at the same hotel, the Sea Hotel Uberfart.
So you're hanging out with the Crown Prince, and you're telling me you were in a capillary sub-meeting of Bilderberg, because I know they have those, or, I know you're not supposed to say. You're just letting me know you were in the area.
All I can say, I was in the area, and many of the people that were there and our members are, in fact, people that I converse with on a regular basis.
Now, I noticed that big palace with three hotels they shut down was right off the bay with all the yachts.
Yeah.
So I guess you were back and forth.
The yachts are great.
What about the, what's on them is even better, huh?
but here's the funny thing, and people listening, all people, if you know the inside scoop of things, making money is the easiest thing in the world to do. That's why guys like, I mean, the economic downturn doesn't affect people at the highest levels.
Exactly. Let me tell you a short story. This is an incredible interview. I met my in-laws yesterday for Memorial Day, you know, eating lunch, and I explained to them about gold and silver trading and about the business. And I said, all you do is basically the opposite of what the mainstream media says to do. And I was telling them 6 years ago at that table, I said, buy gold and silver. Silver's at $5. Gold's at $300. It's going to go up in the next 5-6 years to close to $1,000 or higher. And they go, no, we remember you telling us that, but still they won't listen. And I mean, that's what's so frustrating is that's why it's such a joke to the elite. You can even tell the public the media is lying to them. They don't want to believe it.
No, they don't want to believe it. It's really comical. But let me give you asked earlier about the groups, both Bilderberg, Council on Foreign Relations, and a bunch of other groups. There's in these circles, I would suggest to you that there are two factions, a small faction and a big faction. The big faction categorically believes that they are genetically superior than the rest of the population. But there is a small faction, and this faction are the ones that are feeding me information, probably Daniel Estelin information, and so forth. This small faction are people that really have come to the conclusion that no, some people are smarter than others. Some people are more talented than others. Some people are more, motivated to work hard than others. Some people are lazy. Some people aren't. But everyone should be allowed to succeed or fail based on their own choices and initiative. There shouldn't be two classes. There always will be, but everybody should have the same opportunity. And that's where there's a split and a division right now at the highest levels.
Now, I've been told that it's mainly the younger crowd, and by that, kind of like the Google CEOs and people who are elitists, but they say, come on, we don't have to wipe everybody out, and let's give people a chance. And then there's kind of the old Rockefeller faction that is, I'm 94, launch the operation immediately.
Yeah, and I'll tell you the reason why you're 100% correct there. If you look at the older crowd, they married only within themselves in that crowd. If you remember, you watched the movie Titanic, you know, you had the first class cabin, and the people who were on the first class deck never mingled ever. You didn't even shake hands with somebody who was in first class. And so throughout history, you married and you socialized only with people who were of the same, quote, genetic or DNA structure. Now, there is a lot more mingling of classes, and therefore you get the Google guys or Michael Dells, people that aren't, that were born on the opposite side of the tracks but are making some serious money, and they're not, quote, the right DNA. They're not the right genetics to the older crowd, like the Rockefellers and so forth. And so that's where you have the division, and that's where you have the split. And it's a very interesting time because some of these conversations, and I've been in these conversations, are really thought-provoking and intriguing conversations. I believe that, look, if you have 1,000 people, give everybody the same chance, everybody the same information, because guess what? The smart ones who really want to work hard will succeed more than the other people. But everybody should have the same opportunity.
Well, again, we're talking to Kevin Trudeau, just an amazing interview here. Very, very excited to have you on the show. Dealing with Bilderberg, any other information that came out? Anything else you can tell us that you weren't, you know, told to be secretive about?
I think what people really need to understand is in America, for the next 2 to 5 years, here's what's going to happen. Number one, there's going to be an increased number of people losing their jobs, going from full to part-time, or getting a reduction in pay. So 75% of the people in the next 2 to 5 years are going to have less money coming in. Taxes and fees are going to go up. So more money's going out, okay? There is going to be a level of inflation. And that's still going to be controlled by the Fed, but there is going to be some type of inflation. It's undecided whether they want the inflation to be so rampant where the U.S. dollar no longer becomes the monetary supply of the world, the reserve currency. That's still being debated because, quite frankly, China wants their dollar to be the reserve currency. And is, keep in mind, Bilderberg is owning North America and Europe. And there's another group in a different faction in Southeast Asia. And I've been down there. They're at odds. It's a very interesting.
Who are the Arabs mainly allied with, Europe and the U.S.?
The Arabs are allied with themselves.
Yeah.
They're 100%, and I just was there in Bahrain. basically, they're themselves. It's oil. They know they got about 50 years left, so they're diversifying into banking. You know, you've said it on the show so many times. The first number one way to control the planet or control everything is control the money, and that's control the banks. So that's always number one. The other factor, there's another factor that was discussed at the meeting in Greece, and that is something that no one's talking about. And me and a buddy of mine knew about this 4 years ago, and we've been really heavily invested in this. Water.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you notice European and other companies will pay 10, 15 times what reservoirs and aquifers are worth. They are grabbing it all up, aren't they?
Yes. Water is the next oil. Because if you control the water supply and the mm-hmm. water flows, you have even more control than you do with oil.